Hello and namaste to everyone. So in my last video of arithmetic progression, I have discussed till question number 18 of exercise 5.2, chapter 5, arithmetic progression, class 10, NCERT CBSE textbook. Today I am going to start with question number 19 on page 107 for exercise 5.2, chapter 5, class 10, NCERT textbook. So let's start with question number 19. Subha Rao started work in 1995 at an annual salary of rupees 5000 and received an increment of rupees 200 each year. In which year did his income reach rupees 7000? So I think this is the first word problem which we are facing in arithmetic progression. So let's see how are we going to do this kind of question. So they are saying that Subha Rao started working in year 1995. And in year 1995, she was earning rupees 5000. Her annual salary is what? Her annual salary is rupees 5000. And she is receiving an increment of rupees 200 each year. Okay. So in 1995, she is earning rupees 5000. And 200 rupees is her increment for each year. Now what they are asking? In which year did his income reach 7000? So rupees 7000. Now they are asking in which year. Like if I consider 1995 as first year where she is earning rupees 5000. Now they are asking after how many years will she be earning rupees 7000? Like after 1995, it will take her how many years to earn rupees 7000? So let's see how we are going to do this question. If I see 1995 as my first year, sorry, 1995, okay? If I see 1995 as my first year, then can I say in first year, she is earning rupees 5000? Right? Can I say in first year, she is earning rupees 5000? In second year, what she'll be earning? Can I say she'll be earning rupees 5200? Why? Because she is receiving an annual increment of 200 rupees for each year, right? In third year, it will be 5400. Can we see the pattern here? First year 5000, second year 5200, third year 5400. Definitely we are seeing a pattern here, right? Now they are asking like at which year she will be earning 7000 rupees. Again let us assume that in nth year she is earning 7000 rupees. Okay? Now let's see what we are going to do next. First year, 5000. Second year, 5200. Third year, 5400. Let us suppose in nth year, she is earning 7000 rupees. Okay? Now, 5000, 5200, 5400, and the last term is 7000. Okay, the nth term for this arithmetic progression is going to be what? 7000. And why am I saying this is an arithmetic progression? See, if I see this a1 as 5000, now see a2 minus a1 is what? 200. And a3 minus a2 is also what? 200. And if you are going to constantly write the terms, then you will find that the common difference for this series is 200. So yes, this is an arithmetic progression. And let us suppose that 7000 is the nth term of this arithmetic progression. So now, again using the formula, an is equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. I am using this formula, an is equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. Now see, which is our nth term for this arithmetic progression? Nth term for this arithmetic progression is 7000 rupees. So let me write 7000 here, which is the first term for this arithmetic progression. 5000, right? Clearly, A1 is 5000 plus n minus 1 and D is going to be what? 200, right? D is going to be 200. Now, let's solve this equation. 7000 minus 5000 is equals to n minus 1 into 200. This is going to be equals to 2000 equals to n minus 1 into 200. As this is multiplied here, so if I take this to this side, if I take this 200 to this side, it will come in division. So 2000 upon 200 is equals to n minus 1. Let's cancel this, right? And then 2 tens up. So 10 is equals to what? N minus 1. If I take this minus 1 here, the sign will change and it will become plus 1. So n is equals to 10 plus 1. That is equals to 11. So I can say n is equals to 11. So in which year she will be earning rupees 7000? In 11th year, her salary, So in which year he's going to earn rupees 7000? So in 11th year, so in 11th year, he is going to earn rupees 7000. Let's move on to next question. That is question number 20 of this exercise and last question for this exercise. Ramgali saved rupees 5 in the first week of her year and then increased her weekly savings by rupees 1.75. If in the nth week, her weekly savings become 20.75. Find n. So they are saying Ramgali saved rupees 5. In which week? In first week. She saved rupees 5 in first week and then increased her weekly savings by rupees how much? Then she increased her weekly savings by rupees 1.75. Now they are asking if in the nth week, so there is nth week where her weekly savings has become how much? 20.75. If her weekly savings have become rupees 20.75, then we have to find out the value of n. This is what they are asking. Let's see how are we going to do this. So in first week, she saved rupees 5. In second week, will be 5 plus 1.75. That is what? 6.75. Can I say? In third week, it will be what? 6.75, 1.75, 5, 10, 14, 15. That gives me 8.5. And in nth week, this becomes as what? 20.75. Is this forming an arithmetic progression? Yes, this is forming an arithmetic progression with a common difference of 1.75. How I find out that? See, if you are going to subtract 6.75, if you are going to subtract 5 from 6.75, you are going to get 1.75. And similarly, when 6.75 is subtracted from 8.5, then again you are going to get 1.75. So let's write this in arithmetic progression form. And our nth term is what? 20.75 they have already given us. Now see, our first term becomes 5. What will be our D? Again, I explained previously why this is an arithmetic progression. You can check from here also. A2 minus A1 is 1.75. A3 minus A2 is 1.75. And if you are going to find out A4 minus A3, then that is also going to be equal to 1.75. Therefore, common difference for this arithmetic progression is 1.75. First term is 5 and the nth term is 20.75. Now, all we need to find out is n. So, we will use the same formula. An is equals to a plus n minus 1 into d, where the value of an is what? 20.75. First term is 5. A is what? 5 plus n minus 1 into d. What is the value for d? 1.75. D is what? 1.75. Okay, let's see how are we going to solve this equation.
Thank you.